हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. दिस इज योर जीके क्लास ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड फोर्थ. बेटा, आई एम मेकिंग दिस वीडियो फॉर योर कन्वीनियंट बिकॉज मेनी ऑफ यू आर हैविंग नेटवर्क इशू. सो आई हैव मेड दिस वीडियो फॉर योर कन्वीनियंट. एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द हार्वी वर्ब. जस्ट दिस इज द रिविजन क्लास. वी ऑल हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस ऑल दिस थिंग्स एंड दिस इज योर रिविजन क्लास. And the name of the there are many kinds of animals and there are three categories of them: herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores. Okay, and in the category of herbivores, there are two types of animals on the basis of food that we eat. The animal that eat plants are called herbivores. The animal that eat plants are called herbivores. वो animals जो plants green leaves खाते हैं, that is what herbivores. And the animals that eat flesh of other animals, that are carnivores. And one more thing, there is one more category of animal, that is omnivores. Omnivores, see, I am writing here. Omnivores, see, it's written here. You can see from here. The animal that eat both plant as well as flesh are called omnivores. For example, human, bear, dogs and rats. These are the example of omnivores who eat both the flesh and green vegetables. Okay students, so I hope the three differences of the three categories of animal is being cleared in front of you all. And just read the definition once, that what is omnivores, what is carnivores, because it's very necessary to learn all the definitions. And it's important to remember the example also. For example, the herbivores example is elephant, cow, hai na? These are the examples of herbivores. And carnivores, tiger, leopard and lion, these are who eats only flesh of other animals. That is what carnivores. And omnivores are such a kind of animals who eat both the flesh and green plants. For example, human bears, dogs and rats. These are the examples of omnivores. Okay, the difference between these three are cleared in front of you all. Okay, next we'll discuss about the animal habitat. Already we have discussed once, but it is the revision class, so we have to repeat the revision also. See, for the earthworm lives in underground water or air. See, the earthworm is an insect who lives in underground. And habitat of hippopotamus is river. The habitats of hippopotamus is river. They lives in river. And the shark lives in ocean. This is the another animal, water animal, who lives in ocean. And habitats of the tiger is forest, because they are the forest living animal. They make their den, they live in the den or natural, they make natural shelter where they save their body, and they in that place they save their kids also. Okay, zebra's habitat is grassland, because they are grass eating animals. They are herbivores and they are grass eating animals, so they fully depend on grasslands. Yaks live in mountain, because yak is an hilly areas animal who have a long fur by which he can protect his body in severe cold. Next is crane lives in swamp areas. Sandpiper snake lives in deserts. These are the sandpiper animals, means who lives in desert. Okay, their body is survival for deserts. Next is this adaptation of animal, because this we have discussed many times. I hope you remember all the spellings also: amphibians, mammals, birds, reptiles, insects. These all spellings you remember. These animals are very hard to spot. To survive the winter, they hibernate. Hibernate means inactive. They freeze their bodies, stop breathing, and stop heart beating. They come back to life again after the winter. See, these are the animals who freeze their body due to severe winter, severe cold. उनकी बॉडी जो है वो ठंड की वजह से काम करना ही बंद हो जाती है. इवन दे स्टॉप ब्रीदिंग ऑल्सो, दे हार्ट बीटिंग ऑल्सो स्टॉप, दे ब्रीदिंग ऑल्सो स्टॉप, एंड आफ्टर विंटर दे अगेन बिकम एक्टिव. दिस इज वॉट वुड फ्रॉग, दिस इज वुड फ्रॉग. एंड नेक्स्ट इज कंगारू रैट, द एनिमल दैट सर्वाइव्स विदाउट वाटर. दे हैव अडेप्टेड देमसेल्फ टू सर्वाइव इन द डेजर्ट्स एंड दे गेट ऑल द मॉइस्चर दे नीड फ्रॉम द सीड दैट दे ईट. These creatures are excellent jumpers which can jump up to the 9 feet. This creature is an excellent jumper. It can jump up to 9 feet. Such a height kangaroo rat can jump. Okay, so this is one of the interesting animal also. Next is polar bear. These animal lives in the snow and have thick layer of fat around their body to keep their body warm. Because this is a very heavy animal and having this body, the figure of the body structure is covered with thick fur, so that they can survive in the severe cold, and its body is completely white, and during heavy snow and wind storm they dig deep dens that protect them from the weather. वो जब बारिश जब विंड स्ट्रॉम होता है, हवा आंधी तूफान के समय में बर्फीली क्षेत्र में, ये क्या करता है, बहुत अंदर तक गड्ढा खोद के उसी के अंदर सर्वाइव करता है ताकि वो उस आंधी से बच सके. एंड दे आर द गुड स्विमर्स विच मीन्स इट इज़ ईजियर टू कैच द फिश टू ईट. दे आर द फिश ईटर एनिमल एंड इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट, इट्स वेरी ईजी टू सर्च देम फूड इन द स्नो एरियाज. Next is, this animal can drink and store waters in the hump. It also stores fat in the hump for extra energy. It can open and close its nostril during a sandstorm. It also has long eyelashes that prevent him eyes from sand. This is a dromedary camel who's having long eyelashes because due to the sandstorm, their sands get inside their eyes, so they close their eyes with the help of eyelashes, and their eyelashes are very long, and due to that they can protect their eyes. Okay, so this is the name, this is the picture of this dromedary camel who's having long eyelashes to prevent his eyes from sand. Okay, and it can open close its nostril during the sandstorm. It can close their nostril because the nostril is open, then the sand get inside to the its nose, and it stores extra fat in the hump for extra energy. Means he's a humpy animal, you can say this humpy animal, and it can store the lots of fat for the extra energy also. The shape of this animal help them to swim quickly and catch fish. The emperor penguin, and the shape of these animals help them to swim quickly and catch fish. Their black feathers absorbs heat from the sun, and they also swim in pack of to stay warm. Their black feathers absorb heat. See, this is black from the back side and white from the front side, and it from the back side. Black feathers absorb heat from the sun and also swim in packs to stay warm. It swims to make its body warm, and they only lay one egg at a time. Means they only lay one egg at a time. Okay, you can see the picture of this emperor penguin. Next is stingray. These animals have a flat body and stay near the ocean floor. Their eyes are on the top, on the bottom side. They mostly find their prey on the ocean floor and also hide themselves to dirt if a predator come along. This is the picture of stingray. This is an aquatic animal who lives in oceans. Okay, students, so watch the video carefully and learn all the exercise. See, you just read out all the description what is given here. These are the descriptions of animals, of different types of animals. And rest is this comes to feline cat family. You have to write the five, at least learn five names of the cat family: leopard, feline, cheetah, tiger, jaguar, domestic cat. Like this, you learn the names of, with correct spelling, you learn the names of these cat family. And the portion of your GK is up to the chapter, wait a bit, up to the feline cats, up to sixth, you just learn the chapter. And whatever the extra question I have given you, learn all the extra question also, because these all things are very important. Just read the description what is given here, just for identify the name of that particular things, okay, particular plants, particular animals. Just you learn all the descriptions also, for make your things easy, okay students. And likewise, just do one thing, learn all the spellings and read the chapter carefully, read each and everything carefully. If you will have any problem, you can directly ask me or give me the message. I will explain you very soon, okay. Whenever I will see your message, I will explain it very soon. Afterwards, just do one thing, learn all the spellings of this which is given in this help box. Learn all the spellings, because it's very important to you all, and to learn all the spellings. And up to the sixth chapter you have to learn, up to the seventh chapter, yes, up to the seventh chapter you all have to learn. It's not six, up to seventh chapter you all have to learn. See, there is a correction here, make it once, up to the seventh chapter, not sixth. Up to the seventh chapter you all have to learn, students. So make yourself prepared that you have to learn all these seven chapters. Up to the quiz time, page number 12, you all have to read, okay. See, you all have to read, so take it seriously, take it very seriously. Try tell your parents to collect the copies from the school and try to give the exam, as well as learn the question answers, exercises, complete things, whatever we have given you in an online and offline classes. Learn all the things very clearly. If you have any confusion in any subject, you can directly ask me. See, in GK you have to learn up to 7th chapter. The name of the chapter is quiz time. This is the portion of your GK. In GK, up to 7th chapter you all have to learn, okay, up to page number 13. See, I am showing you from by the video. Just try to learn all the things clearly and make the things very clearly, okay students. And the time is very, okay students, thank you.